of Craftsman Tools, the number one rated brand in America for overall quality, and today's NASCAR teams prove it. Craftsman Mechanics hand tools and toolboxes undergo rigorous testing on the pole tonight, and that car number 95, he's already out there and ready to go. That's Rick Williams. Watson's given the one-to-go signal to the Husky Tool Home Depot late models. The Harry Lane Chrysler Plymouth pace car has pulled in, and it is time now to drop the green flag as Darrell Watson has got the flag in hand. He's ready to throw it. These drivers will come into turns 3 and 4 for the last time before the green comes out. All eyes are on the white stripe. That's when they can start the race. So Rick Williams, Richie Hodge, bring them to the stripe in the green flag wave. feature winner. Mark Vineyard making a strong move to the high side, repassing Mike Weeks for second spot. So give Mark Vineyard the second. Williams will collect the checkered flag, and he'll go on his little victory tour around Atomic Motor Speedway tonight as the proud winner of the first feature event. So Rick Williams drove a fine race, working lap traffic well. Race fans, if you haven't been to Atomic Motor Speedway before on a double feature night, what Rick Williams has to do now, they said, as the NASCAR Weekly Racing Series officials like what they see down there, and Darrell Watson giving the signal. One more time around, and the pace car will speed up and dive into the Knoxville Collision Center. And Charles Walton and Donnie Cameron will set the pace coming out of turn four. You see the white line drew down? And that's where they can start this feature event. So the Knoxville Auto Superstore Modifies feature event is on its way. Caution comes out for the sixth car of Phil Hines out of Oliver Springs as he got shuffled out in turn two. And then we have some more trouble track. So the only car left now is Donnie Cameron down there in the Camaro, number two machine. And he's the outside pole setter. And I see him, they're working on the tire. Looks like the right front now. And it doesn't look like they're going to make it in time. This time by will be Green Flag Racing. Steve Breaker moves up to the outside pole alongside Charles Walton. And here they come into turn four as the Green Flag is coming out. Flag stand, giving the drivers the one to go signal. And Steve Fraker and Charles Walton will set the pace coming out of turn four this time by. In the book, and that would make so your flag stand. He is putting the flag. That means next time by, Green Flag will come out. One lap in the book, 20 lap main event for the modified streak. given as we have the cars back in line. Junior Waters, your leader, with Steve Fraker in second. Walter Sins riding in third in the Nova. Riding in fourth, Scott Gardner with Kent Bradford round out the top five. He took a spin over there. Jeff Myers in the 26 car with nowhere to go. The race fans, Darrell Watson giving the one to go signal as we're now counting caution laps. If you notice the laps going by, we're counting caution laps now as we near the end of the modified street feature event. 20 laps in length. Junior Waters is your leader. Steve Fraker second. Walter Sims third as they come through the cone. Green flag away. And the cost. Crosser Pima pace car pulls off. Tom Patterson and Franklin Seaver have the field, and he'll come to the white stripe out of turn four. We'll be committing feature racing. Please come to the reserve ticket window and see Miss Martha Walker, Maureen Copeland. As Tom Patterson parks his Pinto on the front straightaway. And Darrell Watson's giving the one to go signal. Next time by Green Flag Racing. As Derek Dugan will lead the field around down the back straightaway. Bobby Idol's pulling away in the B2 machine. And so is Derek Elder in car number 20. But he's got a flat right rear. He will not be back out. Here we go, green flag. Palmer in second, Wayne Braden third, Mike Luttrell, and Dango Berg round out the top five. Checker on the start. Derek Dugan, John Scarborough lead them around one more time. This time at the cone, it'll be a race to the finish. Getting his second Pure Mini feature win this year. Of course, he's the defending Pure Mini track champion here. And he's going on his victory lap. Jet Open Wheel Feature Event. Darrell Watson, Blackman in the U.S. Senior Truck Finish Line is given the one to go signal. The 49, but Clayton Turner tonight in car number 7, and the one to go signals out. The next time by will be Green Flag Racing. 7 more laps to go in the 20 lap feature event for the Viking Equipment Bobcat Open Wheel. Signal is being given, so next time around, Three more laps to go. 17 complete. Chad Ogle, Avery coming in second. Mike Lewis. Clayton Turner moves in through the fourth spot. Tony Connolly in fifth. Comes out Tim Weaver, and car number 18 spins in turn two. The one to go being given green white checker this time. Congratulations tonight to Chad Ogle picking up his fifth victory here of the season. The Weekly Racing Series points, the Excise Short Track Division. He has been going jockeying back to
Fritz.
And on the outside in car 212, Tim Kenny. Row 9 has J.D. Jennifer and Richie Holden. Row 10, Tim Adams and Sean Ezel. Row 11 has Charlie Fetterfield and Charles Beatty. So that's how they line up for the Pure Street feature event. The pace cars pull in. The green flag is about to be waved as they come out of turn four. And away we go for the Pure Street feature event. Back in their proper order, so the Tim Adams crew now under the gun, and he's off. So big hand to the Adams ready mix crew down in the Knoxville Cruiser Center infield, getting Tim back under power and ready to roll. Tim stands on it. There we go on the field, and here Tim Ladd comes around with Jimmy Robinette, and we're back underway. Turn four, and he causes a pile up behind him. I see Tim Kilby in car number two, and I believe Jason Maline, as we do have one lap in the book. I do believe your race leader will be the 23 car, Junior Robinette. And
Kingston, Tennessee. He'll put his Adams Ready Mix Monte Carlo. Tim Kilby now with a huge fleet over there on Highway 70. Do a lot of business. The floor, you see the motorsports rescue personnel and the safety crew throwing a little dirt down. Had some fluid. Being shown your race leader in the Adams Ready Mix Monte Carlo. Well, we got them lined up now, and the green flag will wave next time by for Junior Robinette. Stacy Wright in car 71 follows in second with Junior Russell, Ronnie Robines, and David Stewart rounding out the top five. Bell Steinman, turn two. He'll rejoin the field. So the one to go sign being given from the black fan. Junior Robinette, Stacy Wright, Junior Russell in car 27, Ryan Romines and David Schuler will bring them around. Tim Ladd now so slows down the front straightaway. Three laps of 15 on the book. Car. Looks like he might be stuck in the mud. Need a tractor to come out and give him a little push out to his position on the racetrack. Green flag.
Russell in car 27 being shown second. Ronnie Robines in third. David Schuler and Steve Welch round out the top five. Here we go, green flag wave. It's Stacy Wright. So Stacy Wright getting the checkered flag and going on his victory lap tonight. So Stacy going on his victory lap. He picked up his first win of the season tonight. Mark. 201 star of Brian Caffey. Checking one of these teams. The one to go signal has been given. Mark Finger and Rick Williams will lead them around turn three and four. The green flag will be waving in the air. They'll come to the white stripe is where they will rev those motors and go. So Mark Finger, Rick Williams, Mike Weeks, Ricky Hodge bring them out of turn four, and the green flag is out. So we're going to go back green flag racing. Next time by again, complete restart. 20 laps to left of this event. Mark Finger, Rick Williams leading down the back straightaway. Mike Weeks, Ricky Hodge, David Laney, and Kevin Coffey right behind.
Singer and the 441 Market Warrior. So he'll lead them around one more time as we have five stands safely into the Knoxville Collision Center infield.
race car. It's Mike Weeks. Well, the milkman, Mike Weeks, gets the checkered flag from Terry Gooch, and he will take it around for a victory lap. So Mike Weeks. The race fans, hang on. Don't go anywhere. We got a demolition derby. The race fans making their way out. 13 car, looks like it could be a Pierce Street Stock. Good looking car at 13. Got a little sponsor on the side of it. There's a named up car 66. I think I've seen that car before. And want to try to back into that 13 car. Whoa! And we're throwing some mud out here tonight. And people down there in the pit area, I bet they're getting a little dirty down there. Fans, this is a strategic game, and these guys are getting set, trying to get themselves in the perfect order in the fifth machine. He was real close to getting a solid lick on the 13. And of course, he'll go right back up to the top, trying to find some good solid play. And he'll size it up. He's going to 40, got the 13 car again. McCabe. So Jason McCabe is having to go against the Duke.
I'm sure Jason knew this going in, and he had the big boys in with. That hurts the bed for two. Oh, they set him up. Ooh, that's another good shot to the side, driver side. Oh, wait, man, do you remember how good looking that 13 car was when we started this race? We now will need the Knoxville Collision Center into it. Pretty soon. We'll have some repair work to do on that car. And another link to Liberty Station to go. And another, and it's pushing him out. There, Edward Duke put on McCabe. So the hurt coming to life. Have a play on words. But...
delivered. The 13s are taking a beating out there by the Duke boys. These three cars are workhorses. They're taking a good beat in Jason McKay. They took some good shots. They probably wouldn't have hit on that car when it started. They definitely got some now. Hurst has free delivery if you're interested. What they're delivering. Well, these cars taking some parts. It's still rolling out there. Goes outside the cone area. 13 is Jason McKay, then the 66 of the end group. Love battling. In the 66 and Jason McCabe. And trust me, it's the 13. Until now. Still battling out. Both of them on the low side and getting in the mud box. They do the cars pick up. Get some momentum up on the high side of the track. It won't take too much more long. We've got to both these machines. But right now, we've got the 66 might be the strongest. 13 has taken a beating tonight. He takes another good shot to the side.
Hunter has fell off the front of that car of Dixon McKay. And he's stuck. And he just got to sit there. Now the 66 car is being stuck by the bumper. He's not able to move. Thank you.